When we build things in Angular, we often find ourselves needing to do stuff that we see on the web or in other applications every day, like copying text to the clipboard, for example. Something like that could take a little work to pull off if we're creating it all from scratch. But one of the benefits to working with a framework like Angular is that many of these common application concepts have already been figured out for us and made available by either the framework itself, or in this case, the component dev kit or CDK. So in this video, we'll see just how easy this task is thanks to the CDK. All right, let's get to it. For the example in this video, we'll be working with this demo application, PetPix. It's an app where people can share cool images of their pets. Here, we're looking at an image gallery where we can navigate between the images, and up here in the right corner of each image, there's a share button. When we click this button, we get a form containing a message and a link to this image. We also have this copy button. Now, right now, the button isn't wired up to do anything. So when we click it, nothing happens. And it's probably pretty obvious, but we want this button to copy the contents of the form field to the user's clipboard so that they can then paste it in a text message or an email or something else. Well, this is exactly what we're going to do in this video. And it's going to be pretty dang easy to do too. Okay, since we're using the CDK, you'll need to make sure that before you do anything else, you install it using the following command in your terminal. Now, once we have it installed, we will be able to use the Clipboard module to do exactly what we need. And in particular, we'll be using the CDK copy to clipboard directive on our copy button. Okay, let's look at some code. Here we have a slider component that contains the markup and logic for image gallery. Let's look at the template so that we can see what we're working with. Here we have a switch statement that is used to determine which image and content to show. And for each of the images, we have a share component that wraps the image. This share component has a message input that we're using to pass a message and a URL. Now, in a real application, this would be a real link to the image itself. But for this example, it just links to this demo overall. Now, let's take a look at the share component. Here we have the share button, and it's displayed when a message visible signal is false. When this button is clicked, it sets the value of this message visible signal to true. Then, when that signal is true, this message region will be displayed, which contains the text box with our message in it and the button that we will use to copy this value to the clipboard. Now, before we can use the directive, we need to import the module into our component. So let's switch to the TypeScript. Then, here within our imports array, let's add the clipboard module. And we need to be sure that it gets imported properly from the CDK. Okay, now let's switch back over to the template. Now, here on the copy button, let's add the CDK copy to clipboard directive. Now, this directive requires a text value to be passed as an input, so we'll pass it our message input value from this component. And that's it. Pretty easy, right? That's all we need to make it so that this button will now copy our message value to the clipboard. So let's save and see how it works. Let's hit the share button, then the copy button, and at this point, it's hard to know if it worked or not. So I'll paste the contents of my clipboard here into this text area at the bottom of the page. There it is. Pretty cool, right? There's even more we can do with this directive. Let's say we want to switch the text from the word copy to copied once the value has been copied to the clipboard. Well, we can do this with the CDK copy to clipboard copied event that will get emitted from the CDK copy to clipboard directive once the value is copied. To do this, let's add a copied signal that we'll use to toggle the text in the button. Let's give it an initial value of false. Okay, now let's switch back to the template. Now let's add the CDK copy to clipboard copied event. And when the event fires, let's set our copied value to true. So that will change the value of this property. Now we need to swap out the label. Let's switch to string interpolation here, and we'll use ternary operator with our copied signal to display the word copied when it's true and copy when it's false. Okay, there we go. Now let's save and try this out. Let's click the share button, and then let's click on the copy button. Nice, now it switched to copied. And when we paste, we can see that the value is properly copied to our clipboard as it was before. How easy was all of that? Thanks to the folks who work on the Angular CDK, we have a really easy way to copy stuff to our clipboard with the clipboard module. And now you know how to use it. Now, there are many more features available in the Angular CDK, so be on the lookout for more videos in the future. Also, check out my channel where you'll find more videos on the CDK and Angular in general. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.